point. And also, Arsenal youngster, still talking a pretty similar conversation here. Bukayo Saka has earned a call-up to the England national team after a string of impressive performances since the start of the 2019-2020 season. Saka registered 11 assists in all competitions for the Gunners. Under Mikel Arteta, the left-footed wonder kid has been deployed in several positions ranging from defence to the attack. He was born to Nigerian parents in the UK, and Saka was eligible to represent Nigeria. The Nigerian Football Federation reached out to his camp last year, but the response was that Saka needed time to grow and mature before making a decision. However, he's set to become a full England international in a number of days.
Mr. Wana, was there any chance of him representing Nigeria?
First of all, I want to say that Bukayo Saka is not a Nigerian. He only bears Nigerian name, Bukayo Saka. You know, I think we need to understand that bearing the name Saka or Bukayo doesn't make him a Nigerian. He was born and brought up in England. He played his whole youth football in England. He has lived his whole life in England. I don't think Bukayo Saka has visited Nigeria before. Now, I mean, by citizenship, by birth, makes him a citizen of England. You know, sometimes the Nigerian Football Federation needs to wake up to some realities. You know, for the fact that these guys are black and bear Nigerian name doesn't make you feel that you can just have a hold on them. Now, Bukayo Saka, Nigeria's government has not invested anything in this young man, not at the youth level, not at the academy level, not even educationally. So you don't expect these guys to wake up someday and just walk into Nigerian team because they have black skin and they bear Bukayo and all of that.
But has he shown any interest in Nigeria before now?
I don't think he ever had interest in Nigeria. England has always been his home, and his dream was to play for the Three Lions. So I want to say that Bukayo Saka is living his dream right now, playing for the Three Lions. He had never had interest in playing for the Super Eagles of Nigeria.
All right. A similar question with Adama Traore. Do you think he would be able to thrive in the senior team, English senior team, rather?
Yeah, unlike Adama Traore, if you look at Bukayo Saka and what he's doing for Arsenal, and the way Arsenal play, English team, they play long balls, and they like their wingers, very pacey and all of that. Bukayo Saka has got all those attributes. Even though it's going to be a little difficult, but I think Bukayo Saka stands a better chance of playing with the English national team, you know, compared to, you know, some of the stars they have right now. Even though, if you look at the front line in England, it's going to be very big difficult for Gareth Southgate to really pick. But I think Saka stands a better chance because, I mean, he's very prolific, he's very clinical, his crosses are very apt, accurate, and all of that. So for a coach that believes the young player should be able to give Saka the chance. So I think Saka will play. But the problem I have with some of these are black players playing in European countries, by the time he dropped form, it will be the end of you. I'll give you an instance. For instance, there was a time that there were lots of talks about what is the Everton midfielder again? The Gigi Okocha's cousin, his name has just gone off my head. You know, there were lots of talks about him representing England, but if he had played for England right now, it would have been nowhere. You know, but Nigeria, once you get your break and you play in Europe, you can always get a call.
Yeah, so speaking of Iwobi now.
That these guys enjoy. Otherwise, okay.
Yeah, just go ahead. You're speaking of Iwobi now.
Yeah, Alex Iwobi. Thank you very much for that. So, Alex Iwobi, you know, got the call up to England, but there were lots of intervention for him not to play for England. If Iwobi had gotten that cap for England, his national team career would have been over. Now, one of the advantages of playing for Nigeria is whether you sit in the bench. For instance, in that Super Eagles list, we have Ekelechi Iheanacho, who this season has not played 20 minutes. But because of the kind of talent we have in Nigeria, he's been invited to the national team. But the Three Lions, you have players that come week in, week out. So it would have been very difficult for Iwobi to get a call up to the national team. But of course, Super Eagles is an all-comers affair. And I'm sure Iwobi will even go to the next Nations Cup and 3-4 more World Cup. So that's some of the fears I have for Bukayo Saka. When he's not in form, he may not be given a second, third, and fourth chance to prove himself.
All right, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with you in a bit. But let's look
Hello.
At this story.
Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.